Hello friends, welcome to Otika Meditronics company. Today we are going to demonstrate how to use vital sign monitor at your home. So we have bring this device. This is the device which can give you the result of your blood pressure, your temperature, your SpO2 and your pulse rate with a small display. The device is of Contec brand. Contec is having a good quality machine. Model number is CMS5100. So we have done basic unboxing. So we have found this machine. This is the SpO2 pulse rate probe. This is the main AC line unit or cable. This is the temperature probe. This is the NIBP hose pipe and this is the NIBP cuff. So first of all, we'll apply the main power to the device like this. You have to fit this cable. Basically, this device is a rechargeable, so you don't need to connect it all the time. This will give you the battery backup of around 3 to 4 hours, depend upon the usage. And now, whenever you will apply the AC cable, it will give you this two LED indication that the device is charging. So now we are applying other probes. Make sure you are applying into the proper grooves of each connector with a proper color coding. You have to apply yellow to yellow, or it is mentioned here also. This is the SpO2 probe. Fix it like this. Then we will apply the orange to orange. This is the temperature probe. Now, then we will apply NIBP hose pipe. We have to insert this longer part inside of this NIBP holder. Then we will connect this connector to the end of BP cuff like this. Now all the attachments are fixed. Now the device is ready to use. You have to press this power button for 3 to 4 seconds, then device will start on. Now we have attached all the probes. It is giving the finger out error, and this is the symbol of error. The red line is a symbol of error. So we have a patient here. We will apply all the probes to the patient. We will remove this power cord because machine can run on the battery, so you can watch everything easily. Apply probe like this. Then you have to apply temperature probe on the chest part of the patient, or we can say near the axilla. You have to fix it. Hold it like this. Then we'll apply cuff. Make sure this line, this is the artery line. We have to apply cuff like this so that it can fix in a proper way. Now you can see the SpO2 reading and pulse rate readings are there. Temperature is also there. Whenever you want to take the blood pressure, you have to press the NIBP button. Whenever you will press this NIBP button, it will take start. You can see the pressure, the cuff is inflating, pressure is increasing. It will take around 1 to 2 minutes to give you the results in systolic and diastolic. You can see temperature is also increasing. Temperature probe will take around 180 seconds to be stable. You can see plethysmograph is coming here. Blood pressure is getting recorded. It will take around 1 minute. So you can see the systolic pressure and the diastolic pressure given on the screen. So you can see this is how the machine is operated. Basically, you have to go to the menu button. The cursor will come onto the setting mode. Then you have to press OK button. So it will bring you into the internal setup. So after going to setup, make sure current time, and if any new patient is coming, you have to press it here and do yes. Then all the old data will be erased, and from now onwards new data will start recording. We are making it silence so it will not give us a noise. Now after that, you have to select the patient type, whether he is adult, he is neonate, or he is a pediatric patient. Make sure, because this difference will create issue to the neonate patient. Like if you are having setup of adult patient and you are applying it to the neonate and the setting is in adult, then the blood pressure will be very much high inside of cuff, so patient will get irritated. So make sure the patient type is perfectly fixed, pediatric, neonate or adult. Currently we are with the adult. The default button is to default or do the settings all as per the previous data or as the company factory reset data. Then LED lume, this is the intensity of this LED. It will be 1, 2 and 3. You can see LED is getting dim, light and high. So we are keeping. Then key volume on or off, we will keep it off. So this is the major settings you have to do. Then you have alarm settings, you can adjust the alarm from here. Then you can do come to the outside of the main screen, or you can just come to our main screen from pressing the menu button. This is the freeze button, so it will freeze the plethysmograph. This is the NIBP button, from where you can take the blood pressure monitor. This is the silent button, you can press, so the alarm will be there but the sound get silenced. This is the main button, so it will bring you to the main screen. So now we are again going into the menu setup. Then we are going to NIBP setup, from where you can do the setting of BP. If you want to increase or decrease the alarm, suppose NIBP alarm is set as per the WHO standards, you can do it plus or minus from this setup. Then we are going to the SpO2 setup. There is a temperature setup also. If you want temperature in Fahrenheit, you can just change it like this. So this is just a very easy to use machine. You just need to go to the menu and you can do, you can see that now temperature is coming in the Fahrenheit. We have changed the temperature unit. So basically we are pressing main button. Whenever you want to do any modification, press menu button. Cursor will come onto the setting. You can go to the all settings. You can see here the SpO2 trends, it has started. You can see if you will apply it for 24 hours, you can see the entire graph of the patient. Again, we are going to main menu. So this is how you can use this device. Thank you.